This guy is one of the greatest callers in the history of radio. Not this show. In the history of radio. I'm going to take it upon myself to bestow that upon him. He has won this event before. A two-time winner of this event. I said earlier this week, he would try to call. He couldn't promise, but he would try to get free, and he has done so. We have not heard from him in a while. He is back. He has won it before. He is bidding to become a three-time winner. Iafrate joins us. My man, Iafrate, what's up?
Hey, Cheryl, please email me verse 12. First 11 were strong, girl. Hey, Jim, it's nice to be back, and I got to begin with something of a mea culpa. You know, last year I bemoaned the phenomenon of jungle stagnation, and lo and behold, right then and there, the new generation rose up and finally scored a very cool day in jungle history. And so let me begin with congratulations to our reigning king, Brad and Corona. Welcome to the Champions Club. We look out for each other in here, Brad. So as a two-time king of smack, allow me to give you just a little advice. If you should ever be so fortunate as to win this thing a second time, Brad, and Jim and the boys ask you to send them your picture to laud your achievement on JRIB, you send him a photo of the electric smoker, dude. Okay? All right, Brad, your mug went up on that plasma that I won in the 2008 Smack-Off, and my gray matter suffered a freaking bottleneck trying to determine who exactly it was that called and requested their haircut back. Well, was it Ducky from Pretty in Pink? Or perhaps the Till Tuesday chick? Or maybe the Shermanator from American Pie? Or both Wang and Chung? Okay, so that was regrettable, Brad. But one good thing did come of Brad sharing his eHarmony profile pic with the world. After that revelatory moment, we now know why Brad is so pissed at the DDS. I mean, I know, Brad, that, you know, life is not fair, and it is unjust that a nerdy blowhole dentist can get laid while a happening fresh Kaja Gugu alumnus like yourself can't. But what I can tell you, Brad, it's like cash makes the world go round. The ladies love it, and the doctor has it. Okay, and you, well, you, my friend, are from Corona, the self-proclaimed lemon capital of the world. I am not making that up. Corona. A place where, besides lemons, you can find the annual Hostess Ho-Ho Festival and our nation's highest per capita concentrations of carbon dioxide. I mean, it's awesome. My car farts in West Los Angeles, and Brad gets to breathe it. So as witty and clever as you may be, Brad, you just can't have the dentist's women, okay? So ease up, Brad. I mean, it's not Doc Mike's fault that you look like Pete Twinkle sans mustache and live in a cesspool. Okay, but really, Jim, it's more than just Brad. It is the whole new gaggle of Bradettes. And I'm not quite sure where everything went wrong, but when I started calling this program, smack was defined as that bile that comes out of your mouth after you suck on a D-cell for an hour. Hard-hitting, direct, and never cute. Okay, we were short on production value, but long on cracking people in the teeth. We cared less about making you laugh and more about making you cry. So that meant no clever movie resets, no ingenious pop songs, no droll gangster raps from white boys who no black chick would even talk to unless he's our accountant, and even occasional sports takes. Today, by contrast, we have Vic, the great hope for tomorrow, now holding his fourth consecutive ticket punched for entry into the Smack-Off. I mean, has anyone ever done less on this program while being hyped more? Terrence looks accomplished next to you, bro. Okay, let me save you some time this year. Crumple up that losing material you've been editing since Christmas and go with the script written very skillfully for you just this past week. If I'm going to be the biggest bust, I have to own up to it. I used to go to bed at night hoping somebody else like Joe in the OC might magically leapfrog me on all those all-time bust lists. It never happened. And why? Because I am number one. I can't even think of anyone else in the ballpark that might be close to my combination of disappointment and failed expectations. Now that is a smack-off call for you, Vic, okay? And don't talk back to me, all right? Knock it off! I mean, seriously, you guys are the softest bunch of kittens I have ever seen in my life. I do declare that I'd love to have, I'd like to invite Bobby from Brooklyn to come back in here and swing you weaklings over a lamppost by your junk. All right? Instead, the beat goes on. The multinationals have rolled in, and now all we get on this great day is that cheap-ass crap made in China. You know, there was a time when this day's preoccupation might have been whether the ongoing Supreme Court case, Golf v. Being a Sport, had at last been decided by that awesome picture of beloved Masters champion and paragon of family values, our man Hefty, who rolled up to that Krispy Kreme drive-thru wearing his freaking green jacket and toting those two corn-fed, free-range children of his in the passenger seats. I mean, seriously, you know, quick first glance at that photo, and I was like, oh, what a shame. You know, Roseanne has really let herself go again, hasn't she? I mean, Tiger may still be losing corporate sponsors, but it was good to see that Phil is still making a buck wearing his line of Lane Bryant undergarments. Yes, this could have been a different kind of day, but the ground has shifted underneath our feet, Jim. And you know what? I don't want to die as some old-school purist who's unable to change with the times. Yesterday's gone. Yesterday's gone. So let me conclude with this brief letter to you, Van Smacken. Dear Mr. Rome, we accept the fact that we had to sacrifice a whole Friday in radio detention for whatever it was we did wrong. We think you're crazy to make each of us write a 5-minute on-air script that we'll read verbatim, telling you who we think we are. You see us as you want to see us, in the simplest terms, in the most convenient definitions. But what we found out is that each one of us is a whiny Bay City Rollers reject from Corona, and a self-important Hoosier with a relentless weak-ass tagline, and a tiresome rando from NoCal who keeps calling his shot while already ablaze. Does that answer your question? Sincerely yours, the Smack-Off Club. Hey, 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 hey! That's Simple Minds, Chad in Portland, out.
Iafrate! Get smart. Well, that's a very creative call. Very creative call.